disease and starvation. They became more and more difficult to replace and instead were used for the somewhat safer role of logistical support. They were able to move metal to mechanized vehicles over mud and rough ground and were used to carry messages, pull wagons and supplies, and move medical staff, the wounded, and artillery. Horses were purchased for the war from Australia, Argentina, the United States, and Canada, as well as from British citizens. In fact, the country was emptied completely of Shire horses, as they were taken away from their farming families for use in the war. Of course, to make a horse into a war animal, an extensive training regime was required. And what we see here is the act of long rein. This is a crucial element of training a young horse before a rider mounts up, as it teaches them to understand voice commands, the aids to turn left and right, and to halt. It also encourages their confidence and builds trust, whilst allowing the horse to become familiar with the metal bit in his mouth. Long reining is also a useful tool in the build-up to teaching horses to pull a cart, a vital skill for horses of the Royal Horse Artillery, who we also see here.